Hello everyone, welcome to PK's Online Chemistry. Today in this video, we will learn the importance or significance of various arrows used in chemistry, particularly the curly arrows or curved arrows used during the reaction mechanism. So let's see how we do it. So we'll see what is mechanism first. Mechanism is nothing but the step-by-step description of all the events or the step-by-step description of all the elementary reaction sequence that leads to the final product or the specific way in which a reaction proceeds. A mechanism provides a means towards understanding why a reaction occurred. When you understand why a reaction occurred, you are much closer to understanding organic chemistry. Once you understand the mechanism, you will remember the reactions for a longer period of time. So to be successful in organic chemistry, you must know the mechanism for the reaction you are studying. Various types of arrows are used in chemistry, and this signifies or they conveys the information about the particular reaction. And these arrows are resonance arrow, equilibrium arrow, reaction arrow, double-headed curved arrow, single-headed curved arrow, and some of the arrows are also used during the retrosynthesis and in the stereochemistry. So we have seen that mechanism is a common way to know the electrons shift during a reaction. So first let's see the resonance arrow. Now the resonance arrow is also known as delocalization arrow. Now what is resonance arrow? It is a single line with arrowheads at both the ends. So this is a single line with arrowheads at both the ends is known as resonance arrow or delocalization arrow. The significance of this resonance arrow is it separates the different resonating or the canonical structures, that is two different ways to draw the delocalized structures. As we know, benzene is represented by two or more than two structures. For the sake of understanding, just two structures, that is two resonating structures of benzene are shown here, which are separated by this resonance arrow or delocalization arrow. These two structures are separated by this arrow. The second one is equilibrium arrow. The equilibrium arrow has two lines pointing in opposite direction. So these are two lines pointing in opposite directions. It depicts or it signifies a reversible process, that is two structures are interconvertible or the reaction goes reversibly between starting material and the product. For example, this is a simple dissociation reaction of acid in aqueous medium. After dissociation, we get corresponding conjugate base and conjugate acid, and this reaction indicates that reactants can be converted into product, or these products can be converted into the reactants, means the reaction goes reversibly between starting material and the product. There are certain reactions in which equilibrium strongly favors either product side or the reactant side. For example, the amino acids. We know amino acid exists into its salt-like structure or Zwitter ionic structure, which is more stable. And see the length of the arrows. One of the arrows is longer than the other arrow, which indicates that one side of the equilibrium predominates over the other side. So in this reaction, this product side predominates over the reactant side. Second example, its ketone is converted into its enol form. This is enol form and this is keto form, and again we know enol form is more stable than keto form, and see the length of the arrows. One of the arrows is again longer than the other arrow, which also indicates that one of the side of the equilibrium predominates over the other side. The next one is reaction arrow. The reaction arrow is also known as forward arrow. Now this forward arrow or reaction arrow is a single arrow pointing in one direction. This is a single arrow pointing in one direction, and it signifies or it separates the reactants from the products. That is, this arrow is mainly used to indicate that the reaction proceeds in only one direction. For example, benzene plus nitrating mixture, that is A reacts with B to give the corresponding product, means the reaction proceeds in only one direction. Now next one is curly arrows or curved arrows. Now there are two types of these curved arrows: double headed curved arrows and a single headed curved arrows. Now first we'll see this double headed curved arrows or curly arrows. This curly arrow actually indicates the direction of movement of electrons, and there are four possibilities of this movement of electrons, and these possibilities are: first one, the electrons can move from bond to lone pair, or they can move from bond to bond, or from lone pair to bond, and last one is lone pair to lone pair, but this combination actually doesn't work. So mainly electrons can move from bond to lone pair, from bond to bond, and from lone pair to bond. Now let's see bond to lone pair movement of electrons, how the electrons from a covalent bond moves to form a lone pair. For example, tertiary butyl chloride is converted into corresponding carbocation and a chloride ion. This is an example of heterolysis, and as a result of heterolysis, we know what we get is a corresponding carbocation and chloride ion. Now in this example, the tail of the curly arrow begins at the bonding pair. This tail of the curly arrow begins at the bonding pair, and the head of the curved arrow is at the chlorine atom, where it will form a lone pair. Second example is of bond to bond movement of electrons. Now in this example, the tail of the curved arrow begins at one of the bonding pairs of the double bond, that is from the pi bond. This tail of the curly arrow begins from the pi bond, and head of the curly arrow is where it will form a new pi bond. So there is formation of new pi bond at this position. Initially there was a single bond, and after delocalization of these electrons from the pi bond, we get a new double bond at this position. Or another example, where this pi bond is delocalized and we get the new pi bond at this position. Next one is lone pair to bond movement of electrons. Now during this, a tail of the curved arrow begins at the lone pair. This is tail of the curved arrow, and it begins at this lone pair, and head of the curly arrow is at the carbon atom, where it will form a covalent bond. That is, during this movement of electrons, there is formation of a covalent bond between this carbon atom and oxygen atom. So when the electron moves from a covalent bond, it will form a lone pair. When electron moves or shifts from a covalent bond towards a bond, it will form a covalent bond or pi bond. And when the lone pair moves from an atom to atom, it will form a covalent bond between two atoms. Please remember that there is a conservation of the positive charge. In any mechanism, the overall charge must remain the same. The next arrow is single-headed curved arrow, or it is a single-headed curly arrow, which indicates the direction of movement of only one electron from the covalent bond. So it is used in mainly homolytic bond cleavage, where each of the atoms receives one of the two electrons originally present in the bond and two free radicals are formed. For example, the electrons which are present in these two atoms A and B, they are equally shared between these two atoms after homolytic cleavage. For example, bromine after homolysis gets converted into two bromide radicals. Now there are some other arrows which are mainly used in retrosynthesis and stereochemistry to show the phenomenon like disconnection and flipping respectively. So disconnection and flipping, so this arrow is known as a disconnection arrow, and next one is a flipping arrow. This arrow is similar to the equilibrium arrow. The only difference is this word flipping is written over it. So the flipping phenomenon in stereochemistry can be represented by this flipping arrow or this arrow. Now let's see what is the significance of disconnection arrow. Now this disconnection arrow, or this is also known as double arrow, it signifies that the molecule on the left, so this molecule on the left could be synthesized from the molecules on the right. So it indicates that the molecule on the left arises from the molecules on the right, that is known as disconnection process. And in case of flipping, the one chair conformation can be converted into another chair conformation. This phenomenon is known as flipping of the conformation. You can see in first conformation, this methyl group which is at axial position, after flipping it has become equatorial. So the position of the substituent is changed. The phenomenon is known as flipping of the conformation.